My name is Slash Dayton. I never believed I'd find real pirate treasure till I finally found some. So I set out on a quest to capture all my finds onto video. With no big camera crews following me around, I am joined with my pinpointer and my little shovel. I will travel to the most active metal detecting sites, where I will swing my metal detector from night until sundown. Raw. I go extreme. These are my metal detecting adventures.
Hey, everybody. Slash Metal Detecting. Please subscribe to my page. Hit a like right down there. Today, I'm out here with a friend of mine, Jimmy, and we are out here at an old house site. We've both been here before and found quite a few things, so we're going to give it another try here and see what we can find. I've already found an old copper key. He's digging a target right there. Let's see what it is.
Piping. Copper piping.
Oh, it's a pipe. Yeah, that just goes to show we're near that old house site. So let's see what we can find, and then when we do, I'll get you back on. Hey, what's up? Back again. Nothing too special, but Jimmy, he brought me to this spot where I found my first silver thimble. But this guy right here, he found a thimble that was 14 karat gold and silver. It had gold all the way around it. 14 karat gold thimble. How rare is that? I don't even think I've ever heard anybody find a gold thimble. So we're back at this spot, old house site, and we haven't found much yet, but Jimmy found actually a half a horseshoe. I found a full complete horseshoe, so this is a keeper. But he found a broken one. We left that over there by the tree. But it's a horseshoe. It's been a while actually since I found a horseshoe, so I'm gonna keep this one. So me and Jimmy still digging a lot. There's a lot of iron here. Look at that old sign right there. There's a couple signs. Sometimes those are valuable. That's huge though. I don't think I'll be dragging that out of the woods, but wouldn't mind coming back for it because those old signs are worth money. But those look kind of beat up a little bit. He's got a target right there, but my target right there, nothing special. A pin brooch type thing, whatever. The pin's still on the back and it says, actually, the school I went to, Lewiston Junior High Drama Club. Neat. I'll keep it. Why not? It's a local relic. Wow. Cool. Neat. Yeah, there's a lot of iron in the ground in this area, but that's a good sign. It usually tells you that a lot of human activity. We just got to sift through this and we'll find something. So, me and Jimmy, still out here at this old house site. And when I came here, it must have been about 6-7 years ago. It was when I first started metal detecting. I came through here with my HE Pro. Yeah. Good machine, but, today is much better. But anyway, I got my Minelab 700. And he's got the Minelab 900. What a machine that is. It's pretty similar, but it has gold settings. We all know the difference. Anyway, so I come through here, nothing special, but I found a flat button, tiny flat button. If it says anything on it, usually they don't. Sometimes they have a little design. It almost looks like there's a little design there, but it could be just the dirt. Yeah, it's just a dirt. A flat button, tiny one. But it's old, and that's a sign that there's still stuff out here. Shank, still on it. Cool. I'll keep it. Jimmy. Where'd you go, Jimmy? Alright, me and Jimmy, still in the woods at the old house site. I just found that flat button up there, and I come down through here, and Jimmy was yelling to me, said he had a good find. Check out what he's got. Corbel. Wow, that's a big one, dude. Look at the design. Dude, that is cool.
A musket ball.
And a musket ball. Ain't that awesome? Yeah. I love that coral bell. I bet you the dinger's still in it. Oh, yeah, because look how good condition that is. Not even cracked. That is a freaking awesome relic. Man, I can't wait to find a good one like that. Mine's a little bit smaller, but just as nice. But that's a beauty. Beauty find. Awesome. Man, look at that old sign. Almost, I want to drag that out of here. Oh, man. Yeah. Those signs are worth some money. It's an old sign. It's huge, though. Okay. Haviland. America. Ain't that cool? It's freaking huge. Oh man. That thing is worth some money right there. It's huge though. It ain't gonna be easy dragging that out. I might come back for that someday. Jimmy! Yeah, he's around here somewhere. Comes along this hill. In that hole right there. Oh, right there. Get a hit. And I haven't had a target in a little while, so we're ready to head out. Jimmy's around here somewhere. He has his headphones on. I think I see him over there. Maybe. But anyway, I got a hit. Got myself a military button. Cool. Guess it's a button day for me. Flat button. It looks like an army service button right there. Shank's still good. It's a tiny one. It's like a cuff button. Cool. Oh, my stomach's growling. I gotta eat. Awesome. Yeah, just a relic day out here. No coins yet. So, I have found coins out here before, but it was more up there on the trail, what I was telling him. But we're gonna go that way on our way out. But yeah, I'm in an embankment here. It's a little stream. Next to that sign. I think I might come back for that sign someday. That one's in good condition. A little bent, but I can straighten it. But it's not going to be easy dragging that out. But those signs are worth some big money. And I'm going to come back and get it someday when I'm ready to do it. I'm going to have to, like, not bring my detector and just walk in here and come and get it. Which I will for that one. All right. Beautiful place though. A lot of bugs. I'm getting eaten alive. I put bug spray on me, you know how that goes. Doesn't always, it's not 100%. Hey, they still get you. Ouch. Alright. Cool though. I'm gonna go show Jimmy.